Welcome to Growth Island, your go-to podcast on how to be the best version of yourself. Now, let's join your host, Mess Freeze, as he interviews high performers and experts in nutrition, meditation, exercise, relationships, business, general health, and life's bigger mysteries.
Thanks for tuning in again. So this is a special episode where we're going to go really hard, really fast into juice and smoothies. And to do that, I got Thomas Sylvest. He has a master in pharmaceuticals. Yes, that's drugs. So he really knows how different components and different reactions in the chemistry work together. And he's also the co-founder of something called ØkoLyst. The one seeing the video can see. This beautiful brand, they also have bigger juices, but you actually don't need that much if you have the right stuff in it. So I have a ton of questions, and Thomas, thank you so much for joining.
Thank you, Mads. It's going to be exciting.
And if you haven't heard the episode already, we have a full episode with Thomas's journey, how he's been really sick in a wheelchair, 10 years on and off, and how he's without a wheelchair now. He has a kid as well, and he's actually quite strong. I had a session with him in something called Osteo Strong. That's what he used. Who is going to be on the show. He might already have been on when this is live. So he's doing well now. So make sure to check that out. But Thomas, juice.
Yeah.
Why? What's up with that?
So many people use this juice when they are on a healing journey. Because the juice can provide a lot of nutrients in a small package, so to say. So you can... you can get rid of all the fibers from especially vegetables, and then you can power these nutrients in your body so they are more absorbable when you don't have the fibers around them. So that's the main reason why people are juicing their vegetables.
Okay, but sometimes it can also be a problem that you remove those fibers and so on in regards to the reaction and absorption in the body, for example with fruit, which is going to be more just the glucose and the sugar you get in instead of the fiber that makes sure it goes down the way.
Exactly. So I recommend that fruits, you blend them.
Yeah.
Because when you blend the fruit, you get the matrix that binds the fructose, so you get a less of a sugar spike when you blend your fruit.
Yeah.
So that's why... keep juicing for vegetables.
Yeah.
So you can actually end up with a juice that tastes very good, but it's very bad for your body.
Yeah.
So that's a key message. And also when you're talking about juice, it's very important. How do you extract your juice?
Yeah. So let's go into, so we both want to do if you juice at home or if you buy juice, because there's a lot of junk out on the market, but also how do you react? So the first question would be slow juicer or what's it called?
Centrifugal juicers are a cheaper version of the juicer machines. They're very quick, but not so, you can say you don't get, the quality of the juice is not so good. Because when you use a centrifugal juicer, it will press the juice so that the cores where the juice is held is pressed against the side of the juicer in a very very it's a very big force. So you get a lot of you get a lot of oxidation of the components of the juice.
And that's why slow juice is better, because it presses it in a different manner, right?
Yeah, exactly. So the normal slow juice is you have a plate press. So it's basically two stainless steel plates pressed together, and then you can extract the juice. There's no heat developing, so the heat in the centrifugal juicer will also help oxidize the juice. So actually, when you see most centrifugal juicers, you will get two layers of the juice. One is mainly just water, and one is water and foam with a little bit of nutrients in
yeah.
it. But the nutrients are not compared to the slow version of the juicer.
Yeah.
So you can say that it takes a lot more time to slow juice it, but if you are using, especially when you're using a very good foods, very expensive organic biodynamically grown food, then it's a good investment to get the slow juicer.
Yes, it doesn't take that long. So it's
a little bit
longer,
yeah.
But if you have a good slow juicer, it's not that bad.
No,
so it's going to be rapid fire questions because we're going to see if we can keep this in 15 minutes.
Yeah.
So oxidation, that's also one of the important things and the difference between the juice you buy. But what is that and why is it important?
So oxidation, you need to keep your oxidation level in check in your body. So you do that by consuming different antioxidants. And you can do that by juicing, for example, vegetables, or you can put different supplements into your juice to boost the antioxidant effect of the juice. For example, we use chlorella, so it's a microalgae that gives it contains a antioxidant called chlorophyll. So this molecule in plants transport it has a where the human hemoglobin that transport the oxygen in the body. In the plant, chlorophyll do this, but it doesn't have iron, but it has magnesium in the middle of the molecule.
Yeah.
So it's the plant's blood, you can say.
Yeah. But so there's a difference if you leave the juice out for a long time and it gets a lot of air,
yeah.
It doesn't have the same quality.
No, exactly. So
how long can you like leave it out and you still get the same quality?
Yeah, so it depends on the quality of the food that you juice. So if you have a high nutrient content, it can last longer.
So that means if you have good quality fruit and vegetables,
yeah,
it can stand and get air longer without losing the main benefits.
Yeah, exactly. And if you put, for example, ginger or turmeric or some of these compounds that will also protect against microbial growth, then it can keep for even longer. That's why, for example, in our juice we have no sugar, so it's no sugar from fruit or added sugar, and we've added ginger and turmeric to self preserve the juice, so we don't have to pasteurize it. So when you pasteurize it, you heat the juice for a amount of time, and then you'll lose some of the nutrients and the antioxidant effect of the juice.
Yeah. So how long can you leave the juice standing out if you juice it yourself before you don't get the same benefits?
Yeah, I would say it depends. It really depends. So you have to look at the color, you have to taste it, you have to smell it.
Yeah.
But typically when I juice and there's no fruit in it, I don't juice fruit.
No.
No. But I juice a lot of vegetables, and when I do my cucumber and my celery juice with a little bit of lemon, with a lot of vitamin C to also keep the integrity of the juice, then it can stay in the fridge for 4 days with no problem.
Okay, there's something about how you store as well, right?
Yeah, so you preferably you like to store it in glass bottles, in stainless steel bottles. So not any plastic bottles, especially the very soft plastic.
Yeah.
That's the kind of plastic that I would not trust the integrity of the plastic producers, that this will not leak into your produce.
Yeah.
Especially when you have, let's say, ginger or turmeric or a low acid, a juice that is high in acids, then this will interact with the plastic, and then leachable will leach out into the juice.
Okay. So two important things. So just keep the video in as well. So make sure to get it in steel or glass or really hard plastic if you can't get that otherwise.
Yeah.
And I've seen some bottles where you can kind of get the air out after you put the juice in. Same with smoothies. Is that something you would do as well, or?
You can definitely do that, yeah.
And it has a positive effect.
Yeah. So when you, the air will over time help oxidize the content, the nutrients of the juice.
Yeah.
So when you take out the air, when you put it under vacuum, then it will protect the juice. But I don't think, of course, if you have 1.5 liter of air or something like that in the top, that will matter a lot. But typically, it will not matter that much.
Okay. So you wouldn't be super strict on making sure you get all the air out?
No, I will use all my time and attention on getting the right kind of foods. Make sure I know where it's grown, how it's grown, and that it's produced by people that they have a good integrity about their farming culture.
Yeah. Okay. Makes sense. So we figured out slow juicer is best. Make sure we don't get too much fruit in it, even though it tastes delicious, but you can also do that, but then you just know it's more of a sweet drink, which is perfectly fine, and it's better than getting a Coke.
Yeah, exactly.
Get it in a different way.
Yeah.
Make sure to put it in a bottle as fast as possible, stainless steel or glass, ideally. You can get some of the stuff where you pull the air out,
yeah,
but you don't think it's too important, but it is something that does improve it. You can probably keep it for 4 days if you do the celery and cucumber with lime.
Yeah. Yeah, cool. And also get it in a cold place as fast as possible.
Yeah.
So when you have juiced the juice,
would you put it in a freezer or in the, like, would you freeze it down or just
you could quick freeze it. Yeah.
Okay.
So just to get the temperature down to 5 degrees or something like that, and then put it in the fridge.
Okay.
You could,
but you wouldn't get it like frozen?
I wouldn't froze it.
Okay. Does that have any effect on the quality?
I think I haven't read any studies on that actually.
No.
But I would. I think it changes the taste. So we have at ØkoLyst, we have done a lot of trials with different kind of gingers. So we have bought gingers from all over the world. From I think 7 or 8 different places. So we have juiced it, we have measured the pH, we have frozen it down, we have kept it for different time periods, tasted it, and when we freeze down the ginger and we get a funny taste out of it.
Okay.
So we will not like we don't freeze the juice.
Well,
it's
makes sense. And something about pepper?
Yeah, pepper is actually an old Ayurvedic tradition to use pepper when you use, for example, turmeric. So the pepper contains an alkaloid, so it's a chemical molecule class that's called piperine. This molecule acts as a facilitator of the antioxidant curcumin in turmeric,
yeah,
and it really enhances the absorption of this antioxidant.
Yeah.
So in ginger and in turmeric, most of the antioxidants are fat soluble. So they are in the fat part of the roots.
Yeah.
And then you say that's not much fat in ginger or turmeric. That is correct, but if you juice it the way we juice it, we have a masticating juicer, and then we slow it. It first masticates the roots, and then it presses it. So this kind of patented two-step solution makes sure that you get the fat phase out of your roots also. Yeah. So we are able to tap into the antioxidants hidden in the fat phase. So that's why it's our shots are so strong. That's why they can keep for so long in the fridge without going bad. And we also add pepper to the advanced version of this one, because it's very important how you're going to facilitate the bioavailability of the antioxidants. So it doesn't help just to drink it. You also have to, you are not what you drink, you are what you absorb.
Yeah.
So that's why we go to great length in securing that we have formulated the optimal conditions for the bioavailability of the product. That's also why we recommend that people take the shots to food, because then you also have some fat in the food, and this fat will also bind with the antioxidants in the fat of the shot, and then you can increase the bioavailability.
Yeah. So people juicing themselves, it's good to put some pepper in if you do ginger or turmeric to get
especially turmeric. Yeah.
And then going into what kind of juice you should buy, because there's a lot of junk on the market. How do you know that you get a good juice?
Yeah, so
that's actually healthy and not just sugar, because the really cheap stuff you get at least is not really good for you.
No, so the reason I started ØkoLyst was because I could not find a ginger turmeric shop that had enough turmeric to get the antioxidant, the anti-inflammatory effect of the turmeric. And also all the ginger shots were filled with apple. So it was basically a sugar shot with a little bit of ginger and a little bit of turmeric. And so that's why we started to formulating our own shot. So if you're going to buy a commercially produced juice or shot, make sure that you buy from a company that you trust in, that is transparent, and you know where they buy their produce, and they are making sure that the farmers are also taking care of the fields. That is why we're in the process right now, actually, of getting our shots fair trade certified and biodynamically certified. So this means that it's
already organic.
It is of course organic, but it's more than organic, because you can easily get organic ginger from China, for example. I would question the quality of the organic stuff from China. It's another story, but I've seen studies that take into the account the pollution in China and so on. So, and also when we see the roots from China, they're very big and they're very filled with liquid. So you can get a lot of juice out of the ginger. That of course is good for when you're producing the shots, you can make more money, but it's not so strong.
Doesn't have the same good qualities.
Exactly.
I know another juice company as well has looked at that.
Mm.
Getting it from where you're doing as well, I'm not sure it was the same farmer, but from another country instead of from China, just means
exactly.
they don't use as much ginger because it's more strong than you actually also
exactly.
taste. That's also with your juice. So I know some people have tasted them also, like you can actually use it together with water or like mix it up, because you don't need to use as much because it's so potent.
Yeah, it is very strong, and we recommend you that you dilute it before you take too much of it, because it's I see plants as a medicine. So you have to use this.
That's coming from a guy that's been educated in
yeah.
making drugs and medicine.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. So one of my missions with ØkoLyst is to to transform the view on foods and to get the more of the knowledge from the pharmaceuticals, where you have to measure the strength and the potency of your drug. And also, if food is also a drug, then you also have to measure this. So we're also working with the University of Copenhagen to measure these antioxidant levels and also compare it to other products like us in the market, to secure the transparency and to make sure that the consumer has the transparency to take the product where they get the most antioxidant effect for their money.
Yeah, makes sense.
And not just buying apple juice.
Yeah. So cool. I think that hopefully helped people out there. It's really important to look when you buy the juice, figure out who's producing it, how are they doing it. I know you're like, with your background, you go very deep, and we've had a lot of long discussions about how to make juice in the right way. As you talked about, the machine you're using also makes a big difference.
Exactly. It's a very, very expensive machine, but it's all the money worth.
Yeah.
So we get, when we press ginger, we get 90% liquid out of the ginger root.
So that's also from a sustainability
angle,
very important. I know you're also looking into that leftovers, how you can make stuff out of that.
Exactly, yeah. So we're just doing experiments now on using the pulp from the juicer to making super food powders out of that. So that's actually, considering the process where we extract the juice, the potency, then there's actually potency left after drying to make a powder that you can use in your smoothies and bakery and stuff like that. So.
Cool. Any other important things that we didn't get in this short session?
Just get started. Buy a juicer. I don't care if it's centrifugal or slow juicer. Begin. Get some nutrients in your body.
Yeah. And the one recipe that you do yourself, that was?
It's celery and cucumber.
And what's the mix? 50-50?
It's 50-50, yeah.
Okay, and then a squeeze of lime.
Yeah. And remember to juice the whole lime, also the peel. That's where all the vitamin C is.
Okay, so that's important.
Yeah.
Make sure you put that. So one lime for how much cucumber and how much celery?
Just take one stalk of celery and one cucumber and one lime. That would be good. That's for approximately a half a liter of juice. Yeah.
And how long should you take before you drink it? Because that's also a really important disclaimer for people that are not used to juicing. If you jump too fast into it, your stomach is going to react. You need to slowly turn it up.
Yeah. Yeah.
So
exactly.
So the half a liter. How many days do you take to drink that? One day, or is that the 4 days?
That's, for me now, it's just my morning juice.
Okay.
But I will share it with the family, or I'll do it over a couple of days. And I when the stomach and when the digestive system get used to the juice, then you can promote the absorbability of the juice with drinking it on an empty stomach.
Yeah.
So that's why I do it fasted every morning. I take my juice. Of course, there's a little bit of sugar from the lemon, but that's negligible. So that will not spike my blood sugar at all. It will keep me in fat burning mode, and I will promote a healthy digestive system, providing a lot of salts for the gut lining. Yeah.
Perfect. So that was a lot of impactful knowledge that you can use for getting started with your juicing. I'm definitely gonna try to make your morning routine juice to see how that works for my system.
Perfect.
So thank you so much. And
for
those listening, if you share this episode and send me a message on Instagram, there'll be some notes in the show notes. Send me a message there that you share either on your wall or with a personal message, whether it's text or whatever. then you can win a liter of this awesome juice if you're in Copenhagen, and otherwise it can be a session with Thomas over Skype, which can be about juicing or his health journey. So thank you so much for tuning in, Thomas. Thank you so much for your time again.
Thanks for listening to this episode of Growth Island. Be sure to subscribe for more episodes on how to be the best version of yourself. And if you found this show helpful, then please leave us a review so more people will learn about the podcast, or share it with a friend who can benefit from it too. Thank you again, and have a wonderful day.